Welcome to People's Voice. My name is Kali Obi, and today on the street we'll be asking people about the NIN, that's the National Identification Number, what they think about the government decision on it. So come with me on this. Let's do this together.
It's a good decision because that will show that we know who and who are Nigerians. You know, every country has the rules. And I think it's high time Nigeria has to obey the rules that govern Nigerians. There are many immigrants. There are non-Nigerians that stay Nigerian. And they claim to be Nigerians. So by NIN, you show that you are true Nigerians. But government is supposed to space it, give enough time for people to really register. Like I did my own maybe 6, 7, 10 years ago. So when they send a text to me, I next through, I think 246, MTN, and other things. So I don't already. So I have my card long time ago.
And the decision is okay. And I thought they are doing it for our own favor. You understand? They are doing it for our own favor. So that those that are fraudulent, they will be able to detect them.
It's not a bad idea. But me, I believe that government should do it in a proper way. Like someone like me, I have BVN. If government can follow that way and provide each Nigerian with NIN, I think it's the best. Okay, even the way they are doing it now is not bad. But you see some areas, you pay money before they can issue it for you. And the area they're supposed to do it is also be where you can enter from your house to the place, you can do it easily.
Man, I don't find it so funny. Why? Because it can't work. What of my mother in the village? She can't travel from Isi Alangba down to Omuahia to go and register the SIM card. Nor she has an Android phone. It's all those kind of small phone. You call and answer. So we that have Android phone is the only people that can do it on our Android phone. But somebody that has small phone cannot do it there because you can't get the data so far. So it is not easy.
As I'm talking to you now, I want to go and do my own at Izinogba while I stay here in Isheri. It's not fair. So I believe that government should know the way to handle it. It's a good thing to do. But at least through our BVN, they can connect to that NIN without wasting people's time. And the issue of what is happening now, there's nothing one can do about it. It's globally. And the NIN is not bad. I really support it, but they should make it easy for people.
To me, I'm not saying it's not bad, it's bad, but is it secured? Because now we are asked to get our national, our NII number, which we get directly once we click. So it depends on the network you are using. And I just, sometimes I'll get it through and some of them are asking me, where's your NI number? Then I don't know who I'm sending it to and which they can link to all my accounts.
I can see that the decision of the government will not favor Nigeria as much. Because you could see now a lot of people have not really registered. And if you are given an ultimatum of maybe February or so, that will be the deadline, it will not help. And I don't know if Nigeria is as if we have not really arrived in such a thing. Because since they bring out the introduction of this, they are supposed to make it in such way that you go there, you register in some few minutes and you leave. But now we can see that it's not like that and they have made it somehow stressful for people.
Actually, I feel it's a lot of stress because these are details they can get from the BVN, they can get from various information like felt before, because I don't know if a new government come in now, the same thing they are going to do. I don't know why somebody will have to come again and they will have to wait for 7 hours, 8 hours, 9 hours to get information they can easily get. Because if this country were in the 21st century, so I don't know why this information we have to come and queue and queue and queue to keep on doing the same thing.
Some are not really happy about it, and some are really happy about it. But if it will happen, it's going to benefit one, because it's going to stop from all this thief and everything that is happening. It's going to stop them. Then everyone will be fine with it.
Unless government wants to do it, let them go house to house and register it. And the NON issue, it's not everywhere they are doing it. Many people don't know about it. Even me in town, I don't know about it until when I went to passport office. That was when I know that they need new national ID. The old one, I have it. So when I get down there, that was when I know, say, they need new identity card. So that was how I got my own. It has not been easy for people for the registration so far.
For people who are stuck literate, that should be a publicity, that should be a lot enough time for people, and that you bring it nearer to the neighborhood. You see, when you see that, when you have to obey the COVID-19 rules, I watch on television how people are jam-packed in the place. It's very bad. That you bring to the local level for people to come out, maybe street by street, people to register if they really want it to be done properly. It's a good idea, but the government is supposed to space it. They need to get enough time.
I heard of somebody that came to my office yesterday. He's a security person. And the wife came to the office. And he said the wife came because of this NIN. I said, did you succeed? He said he paid 6,000 naira to register. And while we know that it's free, but because of the stress involved now, people have to pay fabulous amount of money to get it, and which is not right. I believe it will not help us. And Nigeria should do, our government should do something more. If they know, the introduction will go, they have to introduce to something to go around. They have to do it in such that it will help everybody. And people will go there and access it freely and go back home.
They have all our, there's database, we have database, they can find all this stuff. But yet, they can't use all this electronics. We hear them spending billions of dollars to get this fixed. But till now, nothing yet. We are still going through the same process. I don't know. It's really painful. And because I had to do my own some days back, and the crowd there, it was so devastating.
If there's any other way of leaking the something, I don't think that should be a kind of an identity number. For there should even if it's going to be, make it simple. All local governments, you can register in any local government. You walk in there, it's easy. It's not something that you have to sacrifice like a week, and yet you not get it. And most of them made a lot of mistakes. You'll be surprised that they will come with a wrong spelling. Your these things when you get your, because I've seen someone that was like, yeah, this is not what I told this person, and you have to, you know, go another process of changing it and everything like that. And once you, that is wrong, the old or your old data in database is wrong.
You've heard it all on The People's Voice on Ibrahim TV. And if you have anything to say on today's topic, all you do is drop a comment on the comment box and we'll reply. So till I come here again on People's Voice, my name will remain Kaliobi. Bye for now.